So in this previous class we are discussing about the deep block of elements, some of the important synopsis of the deep block of elements regarding the case meet JW. Right. So potassium perchlorate and also potassium chloride. So these are the two important compounds of the deep block of elements. Okay, na? So in the previous class we are discussing about some of the characteristic properties. Okay, na? So now the very important the trend of the deep block of elements is that there is nothing but atomic number or atomic radius. Atomic radius and also ionization enthalpy. Atomic radius and ionization enthalpy. Atomic radius. So in the deep block of elements, the atomic radius is varies in three types. Three types are given. The atomic radius variation. First one is considered. Initially, the atomic radius is decreases. Second, it shows some constants. Third, again it increases. So this is the three variations of the atomic radius of the deep block of elements. Now, in modern periodic table, the atomic radius from left to right of the periodic table or again what we know. So when we move from left to right of the periodic table, atomic radius is decreases. Right. So, but in this case, initially it is decreases, afterwards shows some constancy, and also again it will be increases. Okay, na? So initially it will be decreases. Again, it shows some constancy. Yeah, the constancy na show mare tapante, right? So with decreasing the auto, with increasing the nuclear force of attraction, and also increases the screening effect of the elements. So yavaga at the middle of the series, so with the increasing of the nuclear force of attraction and also with the increasing of the screening effect, so both are balanced force are together, so that's why it shows some constancy to the atomic radius. Atomic radius is nothing but constancy na show madute. Okay, na? Again it will be increases and thereafter, so due to the number of electrons it will be increased, so that's why the increasing the atomic radius. Okay, na? So this is the three types of the atomic radius, variation of the atomic radius in the deep block elements, right? And also the next one is ionization enthalpy. I already told that ionization enthalpy and thereafter, first ionization enthalpy, second ionization enthalpy, third ionization enthalpy, first, second and also third ionization enthalpy. Here is the first ionization enthalpy, it is always smaller than the second ionization enthalpy. Second ionization enthalpy, it is always smaller than the third ionization enthalpy. So in the deep block of elements, especially for the 6th group, 7th group and also 11th group, 12th group of elements. Deep block of elements only 6th group, 7th group and also 11th group, 12th group of elements, right? In the 6th group of elements only, the first ionization enthalpy, what is the configuration is? N-1, D5, NH1 configuration. 7th group of elements only, N-1, D5, NH2 configuration. Okay, na? So, what is the 11th group only? N-1, D10, NH1 configuration, N-1, D10, NH2 configuration. So this is the electronic configuration of the 6th group, 7th group and also 11th and 12th group of elements, right? In the 6th group of elements only, configuration is the N-1, D5, NH1 configuration. 7th group only, N-1, D5, NH2 configuration. First ionization enthalpy, it is very less. It is very less. So with respect to elements, we have not go back. So I will give the hint for the ionization enthalpy of the deep block of elements. So with respect to elements, we will study about it, right? So even at the 6th elements, N1 is first ionization enthalpy, it is very low. It only one electron to get this stability. It can only one electron to lose to get this stability. So that's why the first ionization enthalpy is very low. And also here it is half-hand configuration. So it is very high. Again, if one electron is removed, then half field is stable. And then it is very high second ionization enthalpy. But in this case, one electron is removed, then again it is very less, right? And also the third ionization enthalpy, one electron is removed, then loop one electron is removed, then again it is 400 electrons. So it is very less. And also it is very high. So likewise, the ionization enthalpy, it is varies in the D-block of elements. Here this also, only one electron is there. It is very less conversion enthalpy, first conversion enthalpy. In the second, it is very high. And also here, very high ionization enthalpy, here it is less ionization enthalpy. And then here, less ionization enthalpy, it is very high ionization enthalpy. So this is the variation of the ionization enthalpy in the D-block of elements. Okay, na? So yakapa antidre, due to the off-filled electronic configuration and also completely filled electronic configuration. Off-filled electronic configuration. So this is the variation of the ionization enthalpy. Completely filled electronic configuration. This is the variation of the ionization enthalpy, particularly D-block elements. Right? And also the next one is some of the important compounds of D-block of elements. Some of the important compounds of D-block of elements. The first one important compound, there is nothing but potassium dichromate. The first one important compound of D-block elements, there is nothing but potassium dichromate. Potassium dichromate. So yeah, potassium dichromate. So it will be prepared with the using of the chromite ore. So yadrinda prepare maadtare chromite ore inda prepare maadtare. Okay na? So how it will be prepared ante andre, initially chromite ore is converted into sodium chromate. Next, second step is sodium chromate into sodium dichromate. Sodium dichromate. And also the third one, sodium dichromate into potassium dichromate. So this is the different types of reactions. Who knows the more observable. So these are the preparation of sodium dichromate. This is the preparation of sodium dichromate in the D-block of elements. Okay na? So that is the first step we want to do. Chromate ore in the sodium chromate I convert want to do. Second one, sodium chromate into the sodium dichromate I convert want to do. Third one, sodium dichromate into the potassium dichromate I convert want to do. So this is the preparation of the potassium dichromate with the using of the chromate ore. Okay na? So here, the sodium chromate into the sodium dichromate in the presence of the acidified H2SO4 use convert maadtare. Okay na? So this conversion, this is in the presence of KCl, potassium chlorate. In the presence of the KCl, the sodium dichromate is converted into a potassium dichromate. This is the preparation of the chromate ore. And also with respect to the equations from the ore, notebook ore, right? And also the next one is, here is the dichromation, dichromate ore. So Cr2OH2-. Conversion of Cr2O- to 7-2 chromate ore, Cr2O7-. So it is in the presence of the pH of 4. So how pH is going to be dichromate is converted into chromate ore and that is right. So the pH 4 can be another dichromate ore is converted into PN and the chromate ore can convert that. And also these two are interconvertible. These two are interconvertible. You know, right? So when the chromate ore, this is the chromate ore, this chromate ore is converted into dichromate. Yavaga in the presence of the acid. In the presence of the acid, the chromate ore is converted into dichromate. Again, the dichromate, in the presence of the dichromate is converted into chromate in the presence of the alkali solution. Acidic solution is there, chromate is converted into dichromate. Yamaga acidification is there. Other than the alkali solution is there, so dichromate ore is converted into chromate ore. So this is, these both are interconvertible. interconvertible. Chromate ore is dichromate ore in the chromate ore ki convert, chromate ore in the dichromate ore convert maadbekantidre in the presence of the acid, dichromate ore in the chromate ore convert maadbekantidre in the presence of the alkali solution. This is very very important note for the case of neat and also GWB. And also the next one thing here is the sodium chromate and also potassium dichromate. Sodium dichromate and also potassium dichromate, both are acts as a good oxidizing agent. Sodium dichromate into Cr2OCl and also K2Cr2OCl. So ivella namage very good oxidizing agent agi act madutte. But in this sodium dichromate anagutte, it is highly soluble in water. It is highly soluble in water. So that's why the potassium chromate is extensively used in the oxidizing agent in the organic compounds. Organic compounds in the world, potassium dichromate is jaasti use madutaru. Yakappa anta helidre, so because the sodium dichromate is highly soluble in the water, so that's why the potassium dichromate it is extensively used in the organic solvents in the world. Jaasti aagi potassium dichromate na use madta hogutaru. Okay na? So this is also one of the important point. So it is the structure. What is the structure of the dichromate, potassium dichromate structure? Here it is the structure of the potassium dichromate is, here it is. So both the two chromate pore are bonded with the oxygen. Here it is the 126 degree. Here it is the 126 degree and also here it is 163 picometers. Once 120 degree and also 163 picometers. Here it is the structures of the dichromate ore. Okay na? And also the next one, here it is the I already told that it is the very good having oxidizing property. What are the reactions it will be oxidized? It will be converted as iodine to iodine. It will be converted as iodine salts to the iodine salts. The chemical properties iodine to iodine salts ಆಗಿ convert ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. Iodine salts ಆಗಿ convert ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. And also sulfur, hydrogen sulfide to sulfate. Hydrogen sulfide to sulfide ಆಗಿ convert ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. So that is also one of the chemical property of the potassium dichromate. And also it converts ferrous salt to the ferric salt. Ferrous salt to ferric salt. Ferrous salt to ferric salt ಅಂತ ಸುತ್ತ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ವು convert ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. And also stannous salt to stannic salt. Stannous salt to stannic salt ಆಗಿ ಕೂಡ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಿದ್ವು convert ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ. So these are all some of the oxidizing properties of the potassium dichromate. Okay na? And also ಎಲ್ಲೆಲ್ಲಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರಪ್ಪ potassium dichromate ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ, it is used in the primary standard solution of the volumetric analysis. ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ potassium dichromate ಅನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. Because the potassium dichromate itself acts as an indicator. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಅದನ್ನ volumetric analysis ಅಲ್ಲಿ potassium dichromate ಅನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆನಾ? And also it is oxidizing agent for the preparation of the azo compounds. Azo compounds in preparation ಮಾಡೋದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಏನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ potassium dichromate ಅನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. ಓಕೆನಾ? And also tanning in leather industries. Leather industries ಅಲ್ಲಿ tanning purpose ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ potassium dichromate ಅನ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ. So these are all some of the important compounds and the importance of the potassium dichromate. And also the next one is potassium permanganate. Potassium permanganate KMnO4. It is prepared with the pyrolysis of potassium permanganate KMnO4. It is prepared with the pyrolysis of. It is one of the manganese ore. So this manganese ore in the end prepare mantra, KMnO4 na prepare mantra. So yaw thira prepare mantra mantra. So it is fused with the KOH solution. It is fused with When pyrolusite is fused with the KOH solution in the presence of the oxygen, and KNO3 is oxidizing agent. KNO3 is oxidizing agent to prepare the KNO4. KNO4 is prepared in the presence when it is fused with the pyrolusite is fused with the KOH solution in the presence of the oxygen, and KNO3 is the oxidizing agent. In the end, prepare martyr again. KNO4 na prepare martyr. It is prepared with the using of the pyrolusite ore. Okay, na? And also, then it is colored salt. KNO4 is the colored salt due to the presence of the D and D isotopes and also vacant electrons. The unpaired electrons due to the presence of vacant dd orbital and presence of unpaired electrons, presence of the unpaired electrons, this potassium permanganate shows the colored salt or colored solution of the coloring property na exhibit maadute. Okay, na? And also here it is, there is a two types, potassium permanganate and also potassium manganate, right? So manganate to the permanganate, so it is the two forms. So MnO4 minus and also MnO4 2 minus. So it is the MnO4 is the structure of MnO minus. So this is the MnO4 minus. Here it is MnO4 2 minus. O minus, here it is double bond O, here it is double bond O, so here it is O minus. So this is MnO4 minus, this is MnO4 2 minus. So this is the permanganate salt. Permanganate salt, this is the manganate salt. Manganate ion, permanganate ion and also manganate ion. So this is the structures of the permanganate, the manganate ion. And also this permanganate shows the tetrahedral shape. This shows the tetrahedral shape. So here it is also shows the tetrahedral shape. Tetrahedral, both are tetrahedral in shape. And also, this is having diamagnetic property. Diamagnetic property, this shows the paramagnetic property. This shows the diamagnetic property, and also that one shows the paramagnetic property. And also, the color of this magnet is green in color. And also, this one is purple in color. This is greenish in color and also this is purple in color. So this is the difference between the permanganate to the manganate ion. So what is the difference between the manganate to the permanganate ion? So both are shown the tetrahedral structure and also this is diamagnetic and also this is paramagnetic. Because here is there is a presence of the unpaired electrons. Here there is no presence of the unpaired electrons, so that's why it shows the paramagnetic property. It shows green in color and also it shows the purple in color. So here the manganate salt, it is also shows the oxidizing property. The manganate salt shows the oxidizing property. This also shows the oxidizing property. So oxidizing property, ಏನಂತ oxidizing property ನ show ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಆ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ನೇಚರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ when the permanganate it will be heated, it will be converted as manganese ion. So permanganate ಅನ್ನು ನಾವು heat ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಏನ convert ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನಮಗೆ manganate ion ಆಗಿ convert ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆನಾ? And also when the permanganate it is added with alkali, so converted as manganese salt by liberating the O2 gas. liberating the motive gas. Paramagnetic starting in another number, alkyl add molecule. So that converted as magnet ion and also that liberates the O2 gas in a liberate mode. So that is one of the critical nature of chemical reactivity of the potassium permanganate. Okay, na? And also I already told that it shows the oxidizing property of the lead. So it's which are the oxidizing property of the lead? This also converts iodides to the iodine. This also converts iodides to the iodine. This also converts iodides to the iodine. Converts. And it acts as oxidizing agent in all acidic, basic, and also neutral, natural, neutral, medium. It acts as acidic, it acts as oxidizing agent in acidic medium, basic medium, and also neutral medium. In more medium, you can act on the acidic oxidizing agent again. Act on the example, it converts iodide to the iodine. Converts iodide to the iodine again. Ferrosalt to the ferric salt. Ferrosalt to the ferric salt, and also it is oxalic acid to O2 at the temperature of 333 Kelvin temperature, and also it converts hydrogen sulfide to the sulfide, and also sulfides to the sulfates. Sulfates to the sulfates again converts. This is the oxidizing property of the KM and O4. So both in acidic, basic, and also neutral compounds are either acting. Okay, and also some of the uses, killing use of potassium permanganate. So here it will be used in the oxidizing agent in organic salts. Organic salts are the oxidizing agent again used. And also bleaching of wool, cloth, and also silk and textile industries are bleaching that used. Potassium permanganate. And also decolorization of oils, aluminum potassium permanganate use. So then Bayer's reagent. This one is already very, very important. Bayer's reagent. Bayer's reagent. So Bayer's reagent and there is a cold alkaline KNO4. Cold alkaline KMnO4. So this one we can call it as Bayer's reagent. What is called Bayer's reagent? Cold alkaline KMnO4. We can call it as a Bayer's reagent. Here you want to use Bayer's reagent for the detection of the unsaturation in organic compound. Detection of unsaturation. Unsaturation in organic compounds. Unsaturation at detect manavika en martinavo adre in the presence of the double bond or single bond adana identification manavika en use martinavo Bayer's reagent en use martinavo. So Bayer's reagent en indre en namage cold alkaline KMnO4 we can call it as Bayer's reagent anta kerthi. Okay na? So these are all some of the uses of the potassium permanganate. So this is all about the D block of elements. Okay, so next we will move to the F block elements. Block elements. So F block of elements only namu gottide 2 series ide 4f series and also 5f series. 4f series anta heldre the adding of electron in the 4f orbital. 5f series anta heldre adding of electron in 5f orbital. 4f series and also 5f series. So what is electronic configuration of the F block of elements? There is nothing but n minus 2 yeah 1 to 14 n minus 1 d 1 0 to 1 or 1. So ns. So here is the general electronic configuration of the F block of elements. Here the 4f series we can call it as lanthanides, and 5f series elements we can call it as actinides. 4f series series elements we can call it as lanthanides, five-up series elements we can call it as actinides. Here, the lanthanides, it is sorted from 57 atomic number. 57 to 71 atomic number we can call it as lanthanides in the category. Actinides we can call it as atomic number 89 to 103 atomic number of elements we can call it as lanthanide, actinides in the category. Okay, na? So we have lanthanides. Initially the starting element is lanthanide. So lanthanide. So that one we can call it as lanthanides in the category. Okay, na? Actinides in the category, initial element 81, 89 element it is actinide, and also we can call it as actinides. Okay, na? So yeah, it is starts from lanthanide to the lutetium. So this is started from lanthanide to the lutetium, and also it is started from actinide to the lawrencium. Actinide to the lawrencium. Okay, na? So this is starting element is lanthanide, ending element is lutetium, starting element is actinide to the lawrencium. So these are all the elements are very very important. Okay, na? So here all the elements in the five-up series are radioactive. Radioactive in nature. And also here in the lanthanide series, except deuterium, promethium, except promethium, all are non-radioactive. All are non-radioactive. And also general oxidation state of the 4F series shows plus 3, sometimes plus 4 and also plus 2 also. In our lanthanide series, it shows the oxidation state plus 3, plus 4 and plus 2. So it shows oxidation state is plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6, plus 7. Okay, now we have actinide series alone, oxidation state is shown. Okay, na? So this is about the oxidation state of the lanthanide and also actinide series. Okay, na? And also here, these are all silvery, white and soft metals. Silvery, white and soft metals. Silvery, white and soft metals, and also the hardness is increases with increasing atomic number. Atomic number increases, hardness would have increased. And also these are all less basic in nature. These are all less basic in nature, and also actinides are highly basic in nature. These are all less basic in nature, and also actinides are highly basic in nature. This is the some of the information about the lanthanides and also actinides. Still one more important part in account that right? Lanthanide contraction and also actinide contraction. Lanthanide contraction of the lanthanide, so successively decreasing the atomic size by the entering of the 4F orbital scale. The 4F orbital scale is successively atomic size decrease at the lanthanide contraction of the lanthanide. Actinide contraction of the lanthanide, successively decreasing the atomic size by the entering of the electrons into 5F orbital. So the lanthanide actinides and the lanthanide. Okay, na? Lanthanides and the lanthanide, atomic size decrease at the orbital. So continuously, yavaga 4F orbitals ke electron add at the orbital atomic size nimage decrease at the orbital. Adakke lanthanides and the lanthanide. Adhe 5F orbital alli enter at the orbital decrease at the orbital actinides and the lanthanide. So these are also some of the information about the lanthanides and also actinides, right? And also in the next we are discussing some of the important bits asking in the KSET alli previous questions yaro kelidara anadru bagge discuss martta hogu. Okay, na? The D black element, D and F black element, right? Important bits asking in D and F black of elements in the KSET exam. D and F black of elements in the important bits are okay. Note over. Right. So, you can draw previous bits in a question paper in there. Right. Otherly, discuss further. Okay. Na? So, here in the KSET 2014. Question 14. First question was, so which one of these is not known? Which one of these is not known? Right. So CuCl2 option A. CuCl2 option B. CuI2 option C. CuF2 option D. CuBr2. Okay, now so we will work with the copper always exists in the form of plus one and also plus two oxidation state. Copper in the above plus one and plus two oxidation state exists. Plus two oxidation state, right? So all are existing compounds in the which one is not known of the category. Okay, now so here it is. So the oxides of sulfur and also halides of copper compounds, the simple task consists only two elements. Copper react with halogens except iodine. Copper will react with halogens except iodine. So when CuCuI2 it will be oxidizes I minus to the I2. Yeah, oxidize I minus to the I2 again oxidize. So that's why when Cu2 plus will be reacting with I minus, it will use this to the Cu2T. Cu2 I2 plus I2. So this is the by the oxidation reaction. So copper it always exists in the form of the copper Cu2 I2 in the plus one oxidation state. Then we iodine to the exist of the not for the Cu I2 oxidation state with the exist of the other. It does not stable. Cu I2 is does not stable and also it releases the iodine gas. Only the copper it will be exist with the iodine in the form of the plus one oxidation state will matter exist of the. So this is the reaction when copper exists in the plus one oxidation state. Okay, na? So this reaction will go then it will go. So which one element is not one of the Cu I2? Only the copper it will be forms the iodine and the Cu2 I2 formula exist of the. Okay, na? So this is the first question. Right, and also second one. The correct statement is on the grid. First one, the earlier members of lanthanide series resembles calcium in their chemical properties. Second one, the extent of actinide contraction is almost the same as lanthanide contraction. No, lanthanide contraction is better, actinide contraction is better. So there is a difference in the contraction. Lanthanide contraction is different, actinide contraction is different, right? So next, in general, lanthanides and actinides do not show variable oxidation state. Yes, lanthanides shows the variable oxidation state. Sometimes it shows the plus 3, plus 2, plus 1 oxidation, plus 4 oxidation state in a short, but actinides, they can also show the plus 3, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4, plus 5, plus 6 oxidation state. And right, so both lanthanide and also actinides, they can show the variable oxidation state in a show matter. And that is the wrong statement. Right, so next. D, CE, selenium plus 4 is in aqueous solution is not known. No, CE plus 4 is highly stable in the aqueous solution. And right, these three, B, C, D, these three statements are wrong. Only first statement, the earlier members of lanthanide series responsible calcium in their chemical properties. So that is the correct statement regarding the lanthanides. Okay, na? And the answer of the first one. Will not read by elimination method. We can choose the answers for the first question. Right. Next, KSET 2015 will get in the question. KSET 2015. KSET 2015 only questions. Here now.